2 minutes.
Hey, Reba's parents. Glad you're here. Can you see him?
One minute.
Y'all doing good? I forgot one thing that's crucial. You got to be really noisy the whole show. I don't care if you're mad, that's okay. If you're feeling good, let us hear it. But it's really crucial to
30
make
seconds.
The show feel like it's fun. Yeah, that was nice. Yeah, let's try it again on the count of three. 1, 2, 3, make some noise. There you go.
15 seconds. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3.
Hey, wait. I gotta plug my guitar in.
It's only live TV.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. What's up, y'all? We'll do it again. Here we go.
Radio Bristol presents Farm and Fun Time. Live from the birthplace of Country Music Museum in beautiful downtown Bristol.
We'll grab your partner, pat her on the head. If she don't like this, it's feed her cornbread. Girls up in Bristol about half grown. They jump on a man like a dog.
Time's always the best. Thanks, y'all, for being here live from the McLaughlin Performance Theater here at the Birthplace of Country Music Museum. I'm your host, Chris Trulson, welcoming you to another live broadcast of Radio Bristol's Farm and Fun Time. How is everybody? All right. Glad to have y'all out. It is a packed house here, as always, and happy to be back home at last month. Of course, we were at the Paramount. We're here for the next few months. I think the next 3 months we'll be here doing shows at the museum as usual. Folks here in the crowd, everybody, let everybody at home who's watching know you're here. Make some noise, y'all. For folks who are at home, we appreciate you tuning in. You can always join us live here in downtown Bristol on the second Thursday of the month. We would love to see you here for Farm and Fun Time. Tonight's show is going to be a pretty amazing show. We've got the best in contemporary bluegrass and old-time music. On the bluegrass side of things, we've got an all-star band comprised of some of the best ringers Nashville has to offer. East Nash Grass is here. And one of the best leading duos in old-time music, two virtuosos are joining us tonight. We've got Allison DeGroot and Tatiana Hargraves here as well. And for this month's Farm Report, we visited Mike Richard of Glen Mary Farms, a groundbreaking strawberry farm in Bristol, Virginia, that produces some of the most amazing berries ever. Give him a big hand. And also, we've got, of course, the new Farm and Funtime Band, which I'm so proud of and happy to be playing with these folks. Sarah Griffin on bass, Nick Lawrence back there on the guitar, Levi Trent back here on the drums, and Rebecca Branson-Jones over here on pedal steel. All right, we'll sing you an old classic, old Solomon Burke song called If You Need Me. This is an old classic. This one here is one called Stag-a-Lee, and we'll play our version of it. It goes like this.
Night was clear and the moon was yellow, and the leaves came tumbling down. One, two, three, I'm standing on the corner. Stag-a-Lee told Billy, well, I can't let go.
We'll do that one I was ready to do. This one here is called If You Need Me. Lovely sponsors, Eastman Credit Union. Signing loan documents from anywhere. From
more information, visit ecu.org and join Farm and Fun Time and say, thank you, Eastman Credit Union. Hey, thanks.
All right. Thank you, Eastman Credit Union. We truly appreciate your support of Farm and Fun Time. All right, folks, we're going to jump into the first act of the evening. Are you all ready? Good. We've got two of the leading voices in contemporary old-time music here tonight who together reinterpret what banjo and fiddle can do in an old-time setting. Alison DeGroot and Tatiana Hargraves together reinvigorate the songs and traditions that came before them, expanding on the eccentricities of old songs, yet never losing sight of what makes them endure. Their latest release, Hurricane Clarice, consists of old hymns, field recordings, and fresh original tunes, effortlessly blending the old with the new. We're so happy to have these two here with us this evening. Please make welcome Alison DeGroot and Tatiana Hargraves.
Hello, how's everybody doing out there? So great to be here in the birthplace of Country Music Museum. We got to be a part of a really incredible exhibit here, the Women in Old Time exhibit. Anyone get to see that exhibit? It's so special get to have places like this to celebrate our heroes, and then it's really scary to be here. So here we are. We'll see how this goes. No, it's very exciting to be here, and we're gonna just play a bunch of banjo fiddle music for you. We'll start with a tune. Just adjusting my chair. We'll start with a tune from one of my favorite fiddlers named Tex Logan. Got a Tex Logan fan out there. It's called Rabbit, Where's Your Mammy?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Wow. That's like, I'm feeling the banjo fiddle love right now. It's really nice. You know, sometimes you play for people and they're like, huh, that's interesting. And then sometimes you play for people and they're like, yeah, we know. Well, we have Allison DeGroot on banjo.
And that's Tatiana Hargraves on the fiddle. Well, we're gonna do a tune that that I wrote, and then we're gonna go into a tune that we learned from our good friend Mike McGoldrick, who's an amazing flute and piper player from Manchester, England, who plays a lot of Irish music, called Skydance.
We're gonna get tuned up to play another fiddle tune. Just gonna do a lot of fiddle banjo tunes. We're like, should we sing anything tonight? And we're like, nah, we just wanna play tunes. But Well, we're going to play one of our favorite traditional tunes called Nancy Blevins. We learned it from the playing of Albert Hash. And the story goes that there is a woman named Nancy Blevins who was a fiddle player, and she was also supposedly a witch and smoked a pipe and played the fiddle. And when she played this tune, all the little boys would wear dresses and dance. So we like to bring that Nancy Blevins energy with us. She lived in, around Ashe County, North Carolina in the late 1800s. So we like to bring that witchy Nancy Blevins energy with us. We can only play for 25 minutes total, so we can't just play that tune for 25 minutes, right, even though that's kind of what I wanted to do. Well, we're gonna play another original of Allison's.
But first, we're gonna tune. We had somebody at one of our shows say that the tuning was their favorite part. Which I don't think that's a compliment.
Interesting if we didn't tune. Think about how boring we would be if we just played in the same tuning the entire time. Who does that? A lot of people do that. And that's why I don't go out to live shows. No, just kidding. I love seeing all types of people perform, and I love hearing people not tuning as well. I always joke about how hard it is to date just to date in general, because 90% of my humor is so focused around fiddle and banjos that it's really hard to translate that humor to other people. And then I just seem really boring because I'm just making obscure jokes that nobody think are funny.
You're in the right place right now. Thank you. had no idea how long our set was going to be. So. But thank you all so much for listening. This has been really fun to play for you.
Thanks so much to Farm and Funtime for having us. We've heard so much about this show, and it's great to finally be here. We're going to make this is the birthplace of country music, after all, and we're going to recreate a fake source recording of a jig for clawhammer banjo. I'll start with some scratchy 78 noises on the fiddle. That's Allison DeGroot.
Allison DeGroot, Tatiana Hargraves, everybody. Give it up. Make sure to check them out. They tour all the time. They've got their latest record, Hurricane Clarice, and you can go and visit their website at allisonandtatiana.com. Amazing, amazing tunes. Some of the best that old-time music has to offer. Do y'all enjoy that? All right, we're going to switch. Oh, yeah, my cord. Thank you. Thanks, Reba. This is all very new. Plugging in guitars feels very uncomfortable to me. Oh, that's my face. All right. Are we good, Josh? Cool. So we're going to play a few more tunes. Is that all right? Yeah. Before we build up to the main event. Everybody all good? Are you good? Oh, no. Just say no. This is a tune called Before I Grow Too Old. Fats Domino cut this, among many others. And it goes something like this. One, two, three, four. All right. Another one about growing up. It's called I'm Almost Grown. Said I broke no rule. I ain't never been in dust. I don't carouse around too much. Don't bother me, leave me alone. Anyways, we almost grown. I don't run around with no mom. Got myself a little job. I'm gonna buy me a little car. I'm gonna drive around in the mall. One of our great sponsors, Toyota of Bristol. We'll get it for you. This song here is called Toyota of Bristol. With the goal to zero carbon emissions from its vehicles by 2050. For more information, visit toyotabristol.com. We're going to jump into our headlining act of the evening, the closing out the show tonight. We've got one of the most up. Oh, it's time for the, where am I at, man? Things are feeling off tonight, Josh. What'd you do? All right, that's right. Thank you, Keith. Everybody knows the show better than I do. They've been coming for so many damn years. All right, we're going to jump into the Farm Report, which profiles regional farmers, not fathers, strengthening our community through sustainable, eco-friendly practices, helping to positively impact our region's food access and health. Every month, we visit a regional farm and do a profile piece on that farm. And this month, we went just down the Lee Highway in Bristol, Virginia, to meet with Mike Richard of Glen Mary Farms, a state-of-the-art hydroponic greenhouse facility that specializes in growing strawberries. After years of research and development, Mike has mastered the art of the strawberry, and the farm has gone from a small U-pick plot of land to a large-scale operation, supplying restaurants and everyday folks with the superb product that they grow exclusively in their gigantic greenhouse in Bristol. So let's watch the farm report to learn more.
Hello, I'm Mike Richard. You're visiting us at Glenmary Farms in Bristol, Virginia. It started a long time ago when I was a kid. Folks used to take us berry picking up in Connecticut, pick your own farms, and just really enjoyed it. And I then, as an adult, got myself into hobbying as a farmer. One day, talked to my wife and decided to do farming and went back to school and specifically did research in how to grow the strawberries here in southeastern Appalachia and to be able to grow them and harvest them throughout the fall, winter, and into the spring. Went back to school and kind of reinvented myself through that whole recession like so many of us have, and I was doing field grown strawberries. Standing in 6 inches of water, you could smell my berries fermenting a half a mile away. And I just looked up in the sky and said, there's gotta be a better way. And went back to school, did the research, actually went to Portugal and Spain to learn how to grow just like this. And we grow a very good strawberry. It's a form of hydroponic growing strawberries like mass around their roots. We use ground coconut husk as our form of medium. It's a base zero form of soil per se, and it lets us start out at a almost a pure perspective from the ground. It also has a much better saturation point than say just regular dirt does. Keeping the berries off the ground also helps with the overall cleanliness of the berry and the overall quality of the berry. It's just how we grow the berry. It's how we take care of the berry. It's how our employees handle the berries. When you get a box of our berries, you should never have a bad berry. There should never be a berry in there. We strive for perfection with every berry. And we want that person to have that experience that they just look at the berry and go, wow, that's a great berry. You go online at Glenmary Berries, help find your location, where we're selling, the times. Right now we have berries on Valley, right across from Eastern Little League. We're also setting up at the Chamber of Commerce parking lot right there next to the Guitar on State Street. And then we have berries that are now going to be available in Piney Flats, right there on the 4-lane. And also many of the local restaurants are now we've made inroads with our green strawberries into the Nashville market where they like to cook with the green strawberries. Getting out of the office and getting into farming, I didn't realize how soft I was. It's hard work, it's long days, there's a lot of frustration in there, but it's also really rewarding. I never get tired of someone eating a berry of ours for the first time and just looking at me and going, wow, what's that? Like that's just, I never get tired of it. It's just a great berry. And even my kids will tell you that it's a lot of work, a lot of hard work to get to this point, to get that berry taste that good.
And to learn more about food and farming, visit Appalachian Resource Conservation and Development Council website at arcd.org. Big thanks to Michael at Glenmary Farms. And to learn more about their stupendous berries and to try to find out how you can get a box, visit glenmaryberries.com. For our listeners at home, you can always view all of our farm reports on our Radio Bristol Facebook page. at WBCM Radio Bristol. Okay, did y'all like those berries? Yeah, you should try them. They're really amazing. All right, now this is really time to close out the show. We've got an amazing band with us tonight, one of the most up-and-coming acts in bluegrass music. After night playing at a club in East Nashville, East Nash Grass's reputation started to grow. The band, chock full of talent, decided to make a go of it and start touring outside the city to lots of fanfare. Their recent release, Last Chance to Win, has been in heavy rotation here at Radio Bristol. And we're really excited to have these guys here on Farm and Fun Time. Please, y'all, give it up for East Nash Grass.
Tears filled my eyes when you vanished with those gold curls that hung down behind. Said it, almost told her so. Almost told her so. Almost told her.
creature I love. Would she be gone, just traveling on to where I cannot see her, where I can't tell her, almost told her so. Almost told her so. Almost told her.
Thank you so much for being here tonight. Appreciate that. We are East Nashgrass. On the count of three, who are you? Okay, all right. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I feel a little better. We know each other a little bit better. We didn't a minute ago. We are here at the birthplace of country music, Bristol, Virginia. We're very happy to be here. This is our first time in Bristol, and we hope it's not our last. Thank you guys. If you're seeing us for the first time or for the last time and you're just holding out, we appreciate it just the same. This is a really special place, and we appreciate them having us. This is, I think some of us have played here before, and this is the birthplace of country music, where the magic happened, where it was conceived. I don't know what they conceived things to. You know, in more recent years, they've had like funk music and Marvin Gaye and things to conceive to. I'm not really sure what they were conceiving to at that point in time. It was a little different, and they can tell you all about that at the museum. So how about a big hand for this wonderful venue giving us a place of utmost historical importance. We're going to get this gal over here on the fiddle. She is a native of Murfreesboro, Tennessee, and a East Nashgrass original member. We're very glad that she's been with us for many years, even though she's only 15 years old. That's right. That's Miss Maddie Denton over here.
Just a few old bother my mind.
Oh, wow, thank you so much, folks. Once again, that's Maddie Denton on the fiddle right there. And folks, how about founding member on the bass right here, Jeff Parton right there. Folks, he's been playing guitar in this band since 1975. That's James Key on the guitar. Folks, back here on the banjo, one of the original members of the band, that's Corey Walker. Over here on the dobro, before me and him started this band, we were in a rock and roll band together, and I remember one day back then, I said, Dobbin, if we ever get out of this rock and roll hell, we'll start a bluegrass band. Founding member of East Nash Grass, Gavin Largent. On the mandolin, folks, he's from Arkansas, and he's a really cool guy. His name is Harry Clark, and he's a founding member. Give him a hand. Here's one he wrote. It's called Starlit Ibis. Thank you very much. We're gonna ask everyone on stage and off stage please take your hat off for Sacred Number.
Thank you.
Please do not laugh about
Sacred
Number.
Do you guys stay out?
Shut up, Corey.
Hey, be nice before we do Sacred Number. Do we have any people here from Virginia tonight? Anybody from the state of Virginia? What a blessing. Can we get a banjo player off the ground? That's a real question. Get him off the stage for the Sacred Number. He's too wicked. He can't be having that.
All right.
Here we go.
When I was a sinner, the people would say, if you want to be saved, you better pray. I prayed every last till I found the Lord. Jesus promised me a sure reward.
Jesus said, if you'll go,
I'll go with you. Preach the gospel, I'll preach with you. Lord, if I go, tell me what to say, cause they won't believe on me.
put Paul and Silas in the Philistine jail. The Lord put Johnny in the belly of the whale. The whale cast Johnny on the banks of the sea. It ought to be a lesson for you and me.
Jesus said if you'll go,
I'll go with you. Praise the gospel, I'll preach with you. Lord, if I go, tell me what to say, cause they won't believe on me. The man of Babylon were a mighty man, put old Daniel in the lion's den. An angel came down and locked the lion's jaw. Daniel made a pillar out the lion's paw. I'll go with you. Preach the gospel, I'll preach with you. Lord, if I go, tell me what to say, cause they won't believe on me. When I was a sinner, the people would say, if you want to be saved, you better pray. I prayed everlasting till I failed the Lord. Jesus promised me a sure reward.
Jesus said, if you're
in the I'll go with you. Preach the gospel, I'll preach with you. Lord, if I go, tell me what to say, cause they won't believe on me.
We appreciate that. Thank you very much. We are in the process of, woo! That's right. Can everybody get a, how about a big woo right now? Yeah. How about a big, like, 2004 Howard Dean style? Yeah! Yeah! There we go. All right. It's been long enough, you know. We might as well bring back the Howard Dean. Yeah! That really ruined his career, but it shouldn't ruin ours today, hopefully. We're going to be selling some merch out front afterwards. We'd love to meet each and every one of you guys that we can. We had a new album, I think they mentioned, that came out in August of last year. And we're about to start here in a couple weeks on another one. We're ready to go. We'd love to talk to y'all about what outdated technology you want us to put it out on next. We went. What's that?
Cylinder.
Cylinder? Oh, that's a new one. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. Yeah, we've had some requests for cassette, floppy disk, 8-track. We've had a few of those.
How many of you guys have ever committed a felony?
And to that end, we're going to do an instrumental right now written by our good buddy, Mr. Nate Lee. That goes like this right here. Thank you. sure have enjoyed our time with y'all this evening here at the Birthplace. We hope to come back to this beautiful area at some point in the future. If we did, would y'all come back and see us? Yeah. Good. Thank you very much. This is a song that's been quite an evergreen for us off of the last record by the late, great Uncle Dave Macon. Do we have anybody that remembers the Dixie Dewdrop? A couple of you guys. Well, appreciate that. He's from right where our stomping grounds is, Woodbury, Tennessee, and Murfreesboro. So we're going to do this one right here, but without further ado, that's Maddie Denton over here on the fiddle, Harry Clark on the mandolin, Jeff Parton on the bass, Corey Walker on the banjo, Gavin Largent on the dobro. I'm James Key. We are East Nashgrass. Thank you guys for being here tonight. Thank you to Chris for having us, all this wonderful music tonight.
Grass, everybody. Latest record. Last chance to win. Go and check them out at eastnashgrass.com. Did y'all enjoy that? We sure hope so. And some ripping music there. Huge thanks to all of you guys for coming out tonight. We really, really appreciate it. A big thanks to East Nash Grass. Say that five times fast. Allison DeGroote and Tatiana Hargraves. Give them another round of applause. Glen Mary Strawberry Farms and our whole Radio Bristol crew, Josh Littleton up there too. Give them all a big round of applause. Of course, we had a lot of folks watching online tonight, so we want to say thanks to all the folks all over the world. We had folks in Mexico, in the UK, in Germany. So thanks for watching tonight. We really appreciate you being a part of the show as well. And of course, all the folks here live at the Birthplace of Country Music, thanks for coming out tonight. We've got, how about a big hand for the Farm and Funtime Band as well. Help us continue to spread the word. Tell a friend about Farming Fun Time. A lot of good things are happening. We're in national syndication now. A bunch of different stations are picking us up, so you're going to be able to see it on PBS wherever you're at. We're excited about that. And next month, of course, we've got Pony Bradshaw and Nishay Martin Lovett. It's going to be some really, really good songwriters. Tickets for that are just about gone, so go and get them while you can. Listen, RadioBristol.org. And also, don't forget to check out the Farm and Funtime Noon Show, made possible by Permatile Concrete Products, hosted by those great guys, Cody Norris Show. Do y'all like Cody Norris? We appreciate them. They've been a part of the Noon Show for about 6 years now, and they're doing so much for Radio Bristol, so we truly appreciate them. And a big thanks to all of our other sponsors, of course, Toyota of Bristol, AR and CD Council, Bristol Hotel. Thanks for tuning in to Radio Bristol's Farm and Fun Time. That's it for tonight, y'all. Give yourself a big round of applause. We'll see you next time. Make sure to go and support all the artists out here. They came a long ways to be here. So thank you. We'll see you next time.